What's up, everyone? I'm super excited to introduce to you my good friend, Jake Pfeiffer. Jake is the CEO and co-founder of EXP Trips, and although he doesn't really like to mention this because he's extremely humble, by 29 years of age, he has taken EXP Trips to be almost $1 million in revenue per year. Crazy, right? And what he does for work and for fun is he literally takes teenagers and takes them to new exotic places across the country and now recently internationally as well to experience travel and have amazing experiences. Talk about sparking brighter futures for our youth. You're not going to want to miss out on this, guys. Jake has also been to North Korea. Yes, not South Korea, North Korea. And in this very video, he's going to share with you some inside knowledge of what he learned from being on that trip. And finally, at the end, Jake's going to wrap it up by telling you four secrets that he has learned in his 29 years of age to success. Teenagers, you're going to want to jump in on this. You want to get out that piece of pen and paper, and you're going to want to take some notes because Jake provides some amazing, valuable information that's going to really help set you up. Now, when you jump in on this, you may realize there's a ton of people in the bottom that are watching this and able to ask Jake questions at the end as well as at the beginning and get to develop a real relationship with him. How do I get to be part of that? How do I get to meet all these incredible, amazing student tutor mentors that we bring in? Well, you got to join in our Teenage Mastermind program, guys. It's an incredible year-long program where we meet every Wednesday to hold you accountable to reaching your wildest dreams while also providing you the skill set and tools necessary to do that by teaching you how to build blogs, podcasts, goal set, be more productive, organize, discover your purpose, and monetize that blog and podcast or whatever you're trying to do. We set you up with skills that are going to help you thrive in this digital age. And best of yet, we're giving some full ride scholarships right now to be in this program. Yes, full ride scholarships across the entire globe. So make sure you check us out, student-tutor.com, and click on Digital Age Skills on the top right-hand corner of the menu and learn about that program and apply for a scholarship. Well, without further ado, let's get to it. Let's learn all the amazing information that Jake has to share. Let's get inspired. Let's get motivated. And let's go out there, make some action, and together, let's spark bright futures. Cheers.
All right. All right, go for it, Jake. Take the throne. Let's see it.
Sweet. I will take the throne, sir. All right, so let me first get the screen share all set up. While I'm doing that, and you guys can feel free to unmute as long as you don't have any crazy noise in the background, just so that you can chime in as I'm talking.
Or unmute while you're ready to talk, because like you'll hear the mute. When the mute's unmuted, you're going to get annoyed.
All right, yeah. Unmute when you're ready to talk. Can you guys see my screen?
Cupcakes,
if you guys want. Yes.
Thank you.
All right, thumbs up.
Cupcakes.
Okay.
Oh, shoot, I'm not muted. Everyone's a 30.
Oh. All right, so I'll tell you kind of how this is going to go today. Todd asked me to come on and just talk with you guys a little bit about, like he said, my story. And my story is kind of a crazy one. It's been all over the place. Ayin? Yeah. She mentioned that she doesn't really know what she wants to do yet. And that certainly was the case for me. I didn't figure that out until like 4 years ago. And even still, on a daily basis, have no idea what I want to do. So I'll tell you kind of where I'm at today, and then I'm going to give you the super, super abbreviated version of my story. And then I want to give you four what I'll call secrets, even though they're not secrets at all. They're painfully obvious things that all of us can do that I think lead to a beautiful life, a good life, a rich life, which I think is what we're all after. So
really good content.
Right now, I run a company called EXP Trips. How many of you checked out the video that Todd sent you? One. Nice. That's perfect. So I can show it to you again. So basically, EXP Trips is a student travel company. And we have the privilege and the pleasure of basically getting to travel with hundreds and hundreds and thousands of high school students all over the country to crazy places like Scotland, like Orlando, New York, you name it, we go there. So it's a lot of fun. Me personally, I am an absolute fiend when it comes to travel, like giddy. It's my life. I love it. I've made a life of it, and I absolutely can't get enough of it. Other random things, I'm the biggest soccer fan you could ever imagine. Any other soccer fans? No? God. Yes. Yes. I could count on the person from Nigeria to be a soccer fan. So, yeah, travel is basically my life. And today I'm going to talk to you about those four secrets through the lens of travel and entrepreneurship, those two things. But first, I saw this hilarious video yesterday, and I had to share it with you because as we get into the Q&A, and as we're talking about travel, a lot of people, I think that I'm way too excited about travel and a little bit too hyped up, gassed up on it. So I played this for my employees yesterday, and they're like, that's totally you, dude. Totally you. So my apologies if I come off this way. I promise I'm just genuinely excited about travel. Can you guys see that? College Humor Originals? Yes.
That's people in Japanese. Hi, how are you? This is my friend Jenna.
Come on, sir.
Jenna's always going on crazy adventures and traveling places I wish I could go to.
Travel is so important. It leaves you speechless and makes you a storyteller.
Wow. Tell us a story.
I took a picture of a donkey in Puerto Vallarta. So what's your job?
Professional nomad. Student of life.
I got that from your Instagram. I think she means, what do you do that you can afford to travel so much?
How can you afford not to? Travel is the one thing you buy that makes you richer.
Her dad invented you too.
Seriously, everyone should travel.
I don't think I can. I have so many student loans. I'm poor.
So is I. Can I travel?
My boss says I can have 2 days off every week for my weekend. Where should I go?
You have to go to Bali.
Tickets are $1,500 for 25 hours each way.
The world is a book. And those who do not travel, sleep in cage.
You're right. Booked it. I wish I could travel more, you know, but I only get 10 days vacation. I'm already going to 3 weddings this year.
How do you let a man in a suit tell you when you get to be naked in the sun?
Health insurance. Okay, so I'll be in Bali for 6 hours.
If you're in Bali, you have to swing by Bangkok. I mean, it's such a vibrant culture. It'd be irresponsible not to.
There's a 5-hour flight for $200 on an airline where I think one of their planes recently disappeared.
Explore. Dream.
Oh, I booked it again.
Murph, don't listen to her. She isn't enlightened. She's just rich.
Good experience from traveling, okay?
And money. Look, traveling is not a necessity, and I'm happy you get to do it, but please don't make us feel bad if we can't.
Wow. I feel like I really lost myself. But there's one place I always know I can find myself. Travel. I guess it's time for me to hop on a first-class flight to Madagascar and stay in this palace I found on Airbnb. You know what they say? Take only memories. The only footprints.
Why are you friends with her?
She always brings me Turkish delight. How did she get on our roof?
Oh, man.
Hi, I'm Emily from College Humor. Did you?
I love it. I absolutely love it. So yeah, my apologies if I come off that way, but I promise it's genuine, and I think Todd will agree that while traveling is a privilege, you can make it happen if you really try hard enough. So, 4 secrets. Now, that sounds pretentious in and of itself to think that I would have some sort of secret to life or success or anything.
Hey, Jake.
Yeah.
Real quick, you should put your video on until you don't need to.
Me too.
So we can see you.
How do I do that?
Turn off your share screen and go back and forth between them.
That's like next level.
So
that's
just
pro status.
Just click stop.
I'm naive, man. I'll figure it out on the next video, though.
You just click. You can just click. Okay, never mind. Go for it.
Just click stop.
Yeah, you click stop. You click stop, and then you go back to share.
There we go.
Oops. Yeah, so click stop, and then you go back to share, and then that way we can see you when you're talking.
Ah. So wise. Cool. It's me again. I thought you could see me while I was screen sharing, so my bad. But yeah, so trust me, I'm not trying to tell you that I have the mystery solved to life. I don't. But I have had the good fortune to have experienced a lot in my 29 years in life. And this is just kind of the stuff that I've taken away that seems pretty universal and irrefutable. So I'm going to go through those really quickly after I tell you the quick story of EXP and kind of my journey. But the most important thing I want you to remember as we go through this next 15, 20 minutes is that I'd much rather this be a conversation than some sort of presentation. So feel free to click on mute, chime in at any point. I'm going to ask you guys questions at certain points. So please, please participate and just take part, and we'll all learn from each other. That's much what I prefer than just me sitting here talking. So I'm going to give you the short version of the story, but first I'm going to give you the very short version of what EXP Trips is, our 77-second story video. So I'm going to go back to screen sharing.
Mastermind. Look at all these kids. Yeah, Jake is the presenter today, sharing his story on EXP Trips to inspire these teenagers.
Traveling changed my life completely. I developed this need to constantly explore and experience new places and meet new people. I was really lucky in high school to have some amazing teachers who gave me the opportunity to go to those new places and broaden my horizons. I saw how much extra work it was for them, the extra hours they had to put in to give me that opportunity. I created EXP to make those teachers' lives easier, not to worry about the buses or the flights or all of that complicated stuff, but to allow them to do what they do best. Focus on their students while we handle everything else to give those kids the opportunity to explore new places. The real expansion of a kid's mind happens when you hit the streets, when you're trying local food, when you're taking public transportation and seeing all the weird, cool things that take place in a culture. That's where the magic happens. EXP lets teachers do what they do best, focus on their students, while we handle all of the details and give them that opportunity to explore.
Yeah, EXP. Woo. So cool side note, that video was produced, shot, edited, everything by Todd's friend Tony and my friend Tony, who you're, I think, right, Todd? They're going to hear from Tony later on?
Some of them have met Tony already, but yeah, some of them will meet him later on.
Perfect. Nice. Yeah. So it's kind of an interesting road that took me to EXP and what you just saw. When I was in high school, when I was a lot of your age, if you can believe it, I was like the most painfully shy kid you could ever imagine, to the point where it ruled my life. That was my identity. That was everything, was that I was shy. I couldn't talk to people. I had no confidence. And it was honestly miserable. I lived a lucky life and a happy life in some ways, but in most ways, I was like straight up sad all the time. Are any of you naturally like kind of shy people? Yeah. All right. So you feel me. It sucks. And
Jake giving
I was really lucky, like I said in the video, to have this crazy formative experience that changed all of that in the blink of an eye. It was crazy. Are you guys familiar or are any of you in like DECA, FBLA, any of those organizations? Anyone? No? Okay. So basically so Zach, you are. Nice. So basically they're clubs for specific career focuses. The one that I stumbled into, and I say stumbled into literally because my friend dragged me into the class, and I was like, there's no way I'm going to take this marketing class. I don't care about marketing. And he's like, well, they sell cookies and you get to eat them as you bake them. And I was like, all right, sold. I'm in. So that was like my sole purpose for being in that classroom was to eat Otis Spunkmeyer cookies, which are the bomb. And I was lucky enough to have this teacher that, for whatever reason, as I sat there in the back of the classroom where I always sat, my head down, for some reason she saw something. No idea why. And all of a sudden this big bellowing voice comes up behind me and she says, Red! I was like, talking to me? She's like, yeah, what's up, Red? I was like, why are you calling me Red? Oh, my hair, I get it. All right, that's fine, whatever. And she just would not leave me alone. I tried to like go into my little clamshell every single day and she just like smacked me out of it and pushed me to figure out why I was shy, what I was good at, why I was holding myself back. And all of a sudden I was on this new path in this organization called DECA. And literally within 6 months' time, I went from not being able to speak to a single person other than like my best friends, like would start sweating and like run away, to standing on a stage presenting to 2,000 students. And that was all just dumb luck. But what happens, you guys can think of this, what happens when someone gets maybe a little bit too much success too fast? What do you think? Probably can go to their head, right? Yeah, for sure.
They might get overwhelmed.
Yep. Anyone else? Cool. So yeah. Yeah, a lot cocky. Yep. So you guys nailed it. It was this crazy blend of overwhelmed, cocky, big-headed, and I just totally lost myself. I went from being this admittedly shy kid, so I was basically in a shell, not giving anything, but I was also like a really gentle, loving, caring person who put others before myself. And all of a sudden, I went from that person to this arrogant person who was out to get back at basically all of the bullies and everyone that made me, I felt like, the way that I was. So I got this big head and I went into college and I thought I was some sort of hot shot. I joined all the different organizations and was like, all right, I got this whole thing figured out. Whole thing. I'm going to be a commercial real estate investor. I'm going to make $1 million before I'm 30. I'm going to get all the girls. I'm going to do this, do that. I thought that I had every answer imagined. And it seemed like I did. So I went through college like that. I hurt a lot of people. A lot. A lot of people in the same way that they hurt me when I was in high school, which sucks to think about. And then life, as it so often does, has a funny way of smacking you back into reality when you get that way. And it smacked me hard. I graduated college, and I got my dream job in commercial real estate investing. So I moved to California and was staying at this crappy little extended stay hotel, like just not loving life. Put on my suit and tie, did the corporate thing, walked into the office, and every single day that I walked into this office, I walked past a parking lot full of Ferraris, which was cool. And I thought that's what I wanted. But then I'd go inside and I'd see a bunch of middle-aged dudes that looked like they were about 100 years old, never smiled, and every single day came into work, sat down in their chair, sat there for a few minutes, and then called someone and said, hey, I have this big empty building for sale. Do you want it? Yeah, sure, I'll take it. And that was life. That was it for them. So fortunately for me, I'm like stupidly decisive. So 2 weeks into this, now mind you, 2,000 people had applied for this job, 5 got it. 2 weeks into it, I walk into the managing director's office and I said, this isn't for me. She was offended. They were insulted. She said, "Really? Well, then tell me what is for you." "I don't know, but it's not this." And they laughed. A lot of my friends laughed. I had no idea what I was going to do. So I packed up my car and I moved back to Arizona. Show up at my parents' house. They're like, "Moving back in?" "Yep." And I fell back on what I knew, fortunately, which was that same organization that gave me the ability to be someone new. So I started doing leadership workshops for that organization. And dumb luck, as often does for any entrepreneur, hit me upside of the head. And a teacher came up to me that I knew and said, "Hey, we were working on planning this trip, but I really don't want to do it. Would you do it for us?" Now, I'd never planned a trip in my life. I hadn't traveled that much. So I was like, "Absolutely. Why not? Let's do it." And next thing I knew, I had 100 high school students following me through New York for 5 days, and I had never been to New York, which, needless to say, was a pretty crazy experience. But luckily, it went well, and EXP kind of took off from there faster than I could have ever imagined. And it's been really interesting now seeing the evolution of EXP and as it's grown kind of with me as a person, as I've relearned those things that I screwed up on in the transition from shy to confident. And fortunately now I've relearned how to have that confidence without being an arrogant person, without being a cruel person. So now we're in this really, really cool place where we impact thousands and thousands of lives every single year. Teachers love us. People like with love in their hearts say that they travel with EXP and it means something to them. And if I can leave you with one thing today, and we'll touch on this in secret number 4, but it's that the real joy in life, it doesn't come from money. It doesn't come from success. It comes from knowing that you had an impact and made a difference in someone's life. And that's cheesy as it sounds. It's so, so true. And that's what gets me up out of bed every single morning, is knowing that that EXP is actually making a difference for people. You can't put a price on that. You absolutely can't. So you guys ready for the secrets? Yeah? There's only 4 of them. They better be good. All right. So let me pull up. So Todd, I think the problem is going to be that this is a PDF. So
can you share it?
I don't think you're going to be able to. Oh, good call. It's a really big PDF though. How do I share it? Why do I suck at Google Hangouts so much?
You click on the little blue icon.
Got it. All right.
And we can drop it in there. Yeah, I think we're going to move to Skype or another platform. I've been playing around with a couple other ones.
Oh, it has to be a Google Drive link. So. That's fine. We'll just switch back and forth.
Okay. That works.
But really quick, how many of you have ever considered being an entrepreneur or starting your own company or doing something along those lines? Nice. Very cool. Okay, so 2 of you. We got Jackson and Andrew. Cool. Jackson, what do you want to start? You got to unmute a friend.
So I was thinking about for a company. I recently only thought about this, but starting like a skateboard company.
Nice. Very cool. So it's something you love, I'm assuming, right? Skateboarder?
Yeah.
Good place to start, brother. Very cool. All right. So I tried to make these secrets pretty universal. So it's not only for entrepreneurs, certainly. It's just kind of life stuff that I've learned. So let me pull it up. Share my screen first. All right. Jake from EXP's Four Secrets to a Beautiful Life. Yes, indeed. That is a water slide in North Korea. Yes, North, not South. It's the crazy one you hear about on the news. Which leads me into secret number one. Race towards new experiences. This, in my mind, is really the starting point for everything. I think that you absolutely have to experience new things. The people that I know that have been successful, that lead a fulfilled life, much like your friend Todd, they are dynamic people. They are never standing still in one place. They are racing towards new things, new experiences, new activities, new anything to develop their mind further. I think that's how you end up giving the most and getting the most out of life. And you get some cool things when you race towards new experiences. You get stories. You get real connections. You get perspective, which is huge, and maybe a bright idea. I'm going to touch on those right now. We're going to jump back to the PDF really quick. So, I mentioned North Korea. That sounds pretty crazy, right? North Korea. It's a real question. Answer, please, someone.
Because it's a new experience.
Oh my God, they're so smart, Todd. This is great. You nailed it, man. You nailed it. Yeah, because it's a new experience. A lot of people thought I was crazy, and they were right, but not completely, because it's just one of those things that I knew I would come back from and be able to totally justify it, because I'd have this unique perspective on a very interesting situation, and I'd have this unique view of the world because of what I did. And funny enough, the impact it's had on my business has been massive. Because you immediately catch people's attention when you say, I've been to North Korea. So I've had the opportunity to do a lot of speaking gigs about that trip. And it's led to some really cool connections too, which we'll talk about in a second. But first, do you guys want to see what North Korea is like? A little video from my old vacay in North Korea.
How did you decide on North Korea? There's so many options for opening your mind and showing you new perspectives.
That's a great question. So I didn't really decide. It kind of came to me. It's, oddly enough, a nonprofit that finds entrepreneurs from around the world and brings them into North Korea to teach workshops to the people there on different technological skills and business practices. So that's why I went. Crappy enough, like 2 weeks before we were set to go, North and South were on the brink of war, like real close. So North Korea denied our visa that allowed us to do that. So homeboy calls me up and he's like, okay, so visas are denied. You can either not go to North Korea, but you already paid for your flight, you already paid for all that, and it's not refundable. You can't give that back. So, well, that sucks. He's like, option two, you can have a normal vacation for 7 days in North Korea. I was like, hold on one second. What the heck is a normal vacation in North Korea? So again, I wanted to race towards the experience. So this is what ensued. I'll just play a little bit of it for you because it's kind of long. Let me screen share.
North Korea, Jake's experience.
Wow. Seen someone rock an apron so hard in your life? No, is the answer. So I'm gonna stop it there. So the coolest part about that, and the coolest part to me about racing towards new experiences, is not necessarily the experience itself, it's the people that you experience it with. So that trip was insane, and that every person you saw in that video is like world-class, unbelievably smart person. The head of all of Facebook Mobile was on that trip. Literally everyone was either a graduate of like Stanford, MBA, Wharton, Harvard. And then there was me, Arizona State University graduate, 2011, communications degree. So it's one of those things where probably the best part was the people I was experiencing that with. And you guys will hear a lot as you get older about networking. And there is no networking like experiencing new, real things with awesome people like that. Now, here's the kicker. It goes way beyond business. And this is where our friend, Mr. Todd Van Duzer, comes into the story of my life and how big an impact he had in my life. So one thing you got to know about Todd is that with all of his friends, with every single one of us, it's a constant battle where he's trying to get us to go do things. And we're like hesitant. We're like, I don't know, man, I'm kind of tired. And Todd just will not let you not. It's impossible. It's a losing battle every time. So Todd had this music festival that he created. And Munduzer, yep, you guys have probably heard of it. And he was trying to get me to go. He was trying to get me involved, help him out with it. And I was a little hesitant at first, but then I really got on board with it. Lo and behold, racing towards that new experience, something a little outside of my comfort zone, I actually ended up meeting this girl from Turkey that was studying abroad at ASU. You guys know what I'm doing August 8th? 2 years later? 2.5 years later? Getting married. Thank you, Todd Van Duzer. So it just goes to show, like, if you're a static person, if you're not moving towards new things, if you're not experiencing new things, you aren't putting yourself in a position to luck into that kind of stuff, to get those experiences and reap the benefits of doing it. The other cool thing I think about doing that is that a lot of times it ends up paying off in a really big, lucky way. You guys know of GoPro, right? You all heard of GoPro? Sweet company. Awesome multi-billion dollar company founded by a dude named Nick. Would you believe me if I told you that Nick was an utter failure, complete failure? When Nick was probably about 25 or so, he raised a bunch of money from friends, from family, from investors, a bunch to start this tech company. And within like a year, it failed miserably. It blew up. He lost all of their money. There was nothing left. So now Nick's super depressed. He's really bummed on life. He has no idea what he's going to do. He loves to surf, though. So he decides he's going to take off and just surf the world with little money he had left and just figure it out as he went. So he's out there surfing, and it turns out his family back home was like, where the heck is Nick and what is he doing? So he wanted to send them pictures of him surfing, which was tough to do when you're traveling alone and you don't have a professional camera person. So he rigged this shoddy little Velcro wrist strap and a disposable camera from like way back when, the little plastic ones, and he slapped it on there. And then while he was surfing, he would just take pictures of himself and send it to his family. Turns out a lot of the people thought that was a cool idea, and they started wanting to buy them from him. Are you guys ready to see the humble beginnings of GoPro? This is hilarious to me. And an example of how if you race towards those new experiences, you honestly never know what's gonna come from it.
Is it anywhere and everywhere you would be able to simply just pop this up and snap a picture?
This is the first GoPro after he came back and decided, I'm gonna go after this experience again and I'm gonna make it work this time.
How did you come to invent something like this? Well, I was always frustrated that I couldn't easily take photographs of my friends and family during our favorite sports and activities.
Right.
And so I figured there must be an easy way to carry these cameras like you.
Killing it on QVC. Yeah, so you honestly just never know what could happen and what experiences are going to lead you to brilliant ideas or brilliant relationships or whatever it may be. So let's jump back into it and check out secret number two. Be constantly leveling up. Constantly. How many of you are gamers or like video games? Nice, a couple of you. Very cool, very cool. So to me, life is a lot like a video game. And when I play video games, the cool thing to me is progress. When you're building a character, when you're creating a character and getting those new skills and new traits, I think that's the absolute most fun thing. Todd, have you talked to them about SMART goals and going after their dreams and all that?
Oh, yeah. There's an entire class on that.
Yes. Yes. I knew it. I absolutely knew it. Yeah. So I think that Todd's on to something with that. He's not just feeding you guys a line or something. It really is true. You have to aspire to big things. But one thing that I think is interesting and that I fell victim to, during that awkward period where I didn't know what I was going to do, I decided, all right, I'm going to level up. I'm going to figure out everything. I'm going to learn everything. I'm going to do these huge things. So I decided, I was like, I'm going to learn Mandarin in a month. I'm going to learn how to code in every single language in 2 months. And I had all of these like massive ambitions. And then what happens a lot of the time when we set ourselves up for these big, big things in our heads, and then suddenly it all kind of falls to pieces. And next thing you know, you're not doing anything with it. So what I learned through that, and Todd, I don't know, have you mentioned to them anything about like micro goals or like very incremental, small progress?
Yep, that's class number three.
Yes, yes, I love it. Yeah, so it's honestly just miniature goals, tiny little baby goals. And that's how I go about everything now. It's not I'm going to learn Turkish in a month. It's I am going to, for 5 minutes a day, 5 minutes, go on Duolingo, the world's easiest little app, and do Turkish. That's it. 5 minutes. If I can't do 5 minutes a day to try to accomplish something, that's pretty bad. And mentally, I'm so much more likely to do that thing because it's so small. Here's the crazy secret, and Todd can attest to this. Matthew McConaughey had a famous quote where he said, just put your shoes on. It's a weird quote. No. He's talking about running. And he found that as much as he hated running, if he just put his shoes on, if he just said, I'm going to put my shoes on every single day, he would end up going running because he already had his shoes on. Why not? It's the same thing with your goals. If you set yourself up to do that small thing, we're not wired mentally to do that bare minimum thing and then quit. You're probably going to end up doing 10 minutes of Turkish. And then maybe you'll start doing 30. And as you start to build your confidence, suddenly you're like, I love Turkish. This is fun now. It's not a challenge. It's something I enjoy. So I'd encourage you to just try to seek out those skills. Try to learn those things. Because what you're going to find is that it gives you a few things. And let me jump back into our little secrets thingy here quickly. It gives you a couple of things. Down in the bottom right, you see the little ribbon. So it gives you the skills, obviously. That's useful in a concrete way. You can make more money. You have more options. Bam, simple. The Swiss Army knife is because you gain so much utility, and you'll find people coming to you because they know that you have this diverse skill set. You guys are learning, like, what, 100 things in this class? Web design, blogging. What else, Todd? A gajillion things.
Podcasting, goal setting, organization. A little bit of Facebook ads. A lot of stuff.
The list goes on. So you guys are already killing it with this and doing the right thing. And for some of you, you're not even in high school yet, which blows my mind. So I'm preaching to the choir, so to speak. But keep doing that. Keep adding to your skill set. Keep developing that character that you are. Cool? All right, let's move on because we're running out of time. Back into the slideshow. I'm going to apologize to any parents watching on YouTube right now, but it has to be said, figure your shit out. Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, what do I mean by that? Anyone have a guess?
Yes and no.
Yes and no? What's your guess? Something like get a job, be a grown up, right? That's usually when you hear that.
Not really. Just know where I want to head in life.
You guys are advanced class. I love this. Yes, absolutely. It's not about like getting a corporate job or a safe job or being adult-like or anything. It's about diving into the thing that is you. And if that's probably the biggest thing I learned over the course of my life so far, through the shy kid phase to the arrogant phase to where I am now, is the more you can look introspectively at yourself and say, why do I do what I do? Without getting defensive, why does this upset me when someone says this? Why do I get excited when I do this thing? What makes me tick? That's the most powerful thing you can figure out. Bar none, nothing compares. If you can master you, if you can figure that stuff out, you're golden. You're set. Absolutely. Todd, have you talked to them about like core values and stuff like that?
Yeah, that's class number one.
I love it, man. Why wasn't I in this class? Yeah, so, you know, it's kind of confusing, and life is ridiculous. I'll be the first to say it's going to throw crap at you that you can't even imagine and expect. One thing will get you through that, and you guys get a head start. That's having a foundation with those core values, with beliefs that you know that you can go into a tough situation, measure it up to those core values, and then say, okay, it's pretty simple. I go this way because I believe this, because I know I am this way and this is what I need to do. 100%, that's the best thing you can figure out. Okay, back to our thing. Last secret, you guys ready? It's a good one. It's the biggest secret of all.
Don't complain.
Make other people smile. It's so simple. Unbelievably simple. Let me stop sharing. This is one of the crazy things. So when I went through high school and I changed from that shy kid and became the arrogant person, I thought that the way you got people to respect you, that the way you got people to like you and the way you succeeded was by being smarter than them, was by having the answers, was by working harder. Would you believe me if I said that's complete, complete BS? What I've learned in 29 years is that whether it's a girlfriend, a boyfriend, your parents, your friends, work, if you can make people smile genuinely, if you can be someone that people enjoy being around, you're set. You're 100% set. And here's the crazy thing, is that as you make people smile, as you give more of yourself than you take from others, more of your knowledge, more of your value than you take from others, that's the most selfish thing you can do. It is a selfish act, a self-serving act. And I mean that in the best way possible. Because how good do you guys feel when you do something that makes someone else smile? Right? Who's had an experience like that where you put someone way before yourself, I mean light years before yourself, and they just smile? Maybe they didn't even say thank you. That's pretty cool, right? Yeah, I agree. So that to me was the biggest realization I've had in 29 years, is that we as individuals have a tremendous amount of power. More than we know, more than you know, more than you know. And that power is that we can either make or break people's experiences with the way that we are. The way that you come into experiences, relationships, can literally change people's lives. That's pretty scary. So if you master one of these things, the others are important, but make it this one, because the rest tends to work itself out. If you can be a good person, objectively good, and make other people happy, life is going to show you kindness. It's going to pay you back, I guarantee you. And on that note, I'm going to show you a really quick video just to hammer that point home. And then I will let Todd take it away. Awesome though, that's real, that's like concrete goodness whereas business success, all that, it's all well and good, but that's what matters right there. So that's what I'll leave you guys with. I know we're pretty much out of time. I'm happy to answer a couple quick questions, though, if Todd, you want to do that.
Yeah.
Wow. That was good. To be honest, I wasn't quite expecting it to be that good. I mean, I knew Jake would be a good speaker. I knew he had information, but I took some notes here. Quality, good stuff, right? Really good information. And I really like the last part, really about smiling, you know, getting people to smile more. And it's so important. Like, you know, life is not just all about chasing that next thing. It's about providing value and helping others, putting a smile on their face. And it really does bring fulfillment to you when you see someone smile, you know. Smile. Just try it right now. It makes you feel good, right? So, guys, thanks so much for joining us. We'll have another speaker probably in a month or so. In 1 month, we have a new speaker. And if you haven't already yet, make sure you check out the Teenage Digital Age Mastermind course. There's full ride scholarships available right now, so you have nothing to lose. And you can join this program for completely free. Not only are you going to meet amazing people like Jake on a monthly basis, soon to be bi-weekly, you can also meet other teenagers from across the world. If you saw right there, we have someone actually from Nigeria. We have someone from Texas, Arizona. The program's just recently been developed, and we're adding tons and tons of new people into this program weekly. So we hope you join us. So not only can you expand your network and be surrounded by other ambitious teenagers from across the world and meet people like Jake and be inspired and motivated and learn proven tips and as well as have the ability to create a relationship with him and ask questions, but also to learn the 6 digital age courses that you go through in this class. You learn goal setting, productivity, organization, how to build a blog or podcast, how to monetize it, so much valuable information. I will also get to meet you, get to know you at more than just a skin deep level. Truly here to help spark bright futures. And teenagers, I hope you check it out. I hope you apply for a scholarship. And I hope that you check out our next video for our next incredible speaker that we're going to be having you in a month. So thanks so much for watching. I appreciate it. If this is YouTube, give us a thumbs up. Give us a comment below. Give us a share. We would really appreciate the gratitude. Thanks again, and I'll see you. Have a good night. Well, I guess good night for me. Possibly good morning. Good afternoon. Smile.